They took Fergus! Hi everyone, I'm Sandrine and welcome to New Outlander Review. This week's episode was called The Fox's Lair. Let's talk about it. First, some quick thoughts. I love that they changed the opening song back to English with a Scottish feel now that we're back in Scotland. I remember going like, oh my god, it's in English now! Yay! They took Fergus! Yes! I mean, I kind of expected them to take Fergus because why would they leave him there? But still, I was so excited when I saw him. I was like, they took him! Oh, Fergus. The scene where Jamie is holding his baby nephew was so heartbreaking and emotional with Claire watching, especially that you know they just lost their baby. I was like, oh. It was also really nice to see Colin McKenzie. I know he was not there really to help Jamie and Claire, but it kind of reminded me of season one, and I was like, Colin! It's like seeing an old friend. I'm actually really excited to see Dougal and the other boys again, so hopefully we get to that pretty soon. And while I was excited to see Colin, I wasn't too excited to see Leary, who I think is still in love with Jamie. I mean, I think it's pretty obvious that she hasn't given up on him and, you know, getting him and all of that, which is not good news for Claire and Jamie, because I really don't think she's learned from her mistakes. Now, let's talk about the new plan that Jamie and Claire have. So Jamie and Claire are back in Scotland. Unfortunately, the excitement of being back is short-lived. Jamie's cousin forged his signature, sort of outing him as a traitor. So now, change of plans, instead of trying to stop the Jacobite rebellion, they're gonna try and win. It's kind of like by trying to change the future, they made everything worse because not only did they not stop the rebellion, now they're completely involved in it, and if they don't win, then they're gonna be traitors and sentenced to death. I mean, it's just really bad. And I keep thinking every time that this happens about this show called 11-22-63, which is based on a book by Stephen King, in which a guy goes to the past and tries to prevent Kennedy's assassination. And there's this idea in the book that the past fights back against you trying to change the future. And I feel that's kind of what's happening here, where no matter what they try to do, there's something that always happens to prevent them from doing it. So no matter what Jamie and Claire do, the past, their universe is kind of pushing back against them to make sure that whatever happened, happened, if that makes sense. So I kind of like this idea from that show, and I really think it applies a little bit here, because that's what I kept thinking. I was like, yeah, no matter what they do, it just seems to kind of get worse, and they're still not achieving what they wanted to achieve. So, and actually, if you think about Claire going to the present again, and it seems that obviously didn't stop anything, so really, it feels like the past won. But, you know, that's just a side note. Back to this week's episode, we meet Jamie's grandfather, who, you know, is not the nicest guy. Really, he's just looking out for himself. Because at the end of the day, he literally set himself up to come out ahead, no matter the outcome. If the Jacobites win, then he can say, I helped you guys win. And if they don't win, then he can say that his son kind of betrayed him, took some men, and he has an agreement to prove that he was gonna stay out of it. So really kind of smart in a way. And I love that Jamie used the story again for La Dame Blanche and made everyone afraid of Claire once again. This is starting to be a really good story to keep Claire out of danger. So yeah, La Dame Blanche is like the best story that Jamie has ever come up with. And of course you gotta love her pretending to have the vision based on what the seer had told her. And, you know, it probably wouldn't work nowadays, but then, you know, you're just like, and that's all I have for this episode. I mean, it was a lot quieter, a lot less things happened than obviously the last two episodes, I think. I feel like they are easing us back into Scotland. A little calm before the storm, for sure, because this is Outlander. That's kind of what they do. They do, oh, it's calm, it's calm, it's crazy, it's crazy, it's calm, it's calm, it's calm, it's crazy, it's crazy, it's calm, it's calm, it's calm, it's crazy, it's crazy, it's crazy, it's crazy. Overall, enjoyed it. Of course, best part was that Fergus is with them. Because yeah. But those were my thoughts. Of course, I'd love to hear what you thought of this episode. Were you excited that Fergus was with them? What do you think of Claire and Jamie's new plan to now try and win the battle? Let me know in the comments. Don't forget to subscribe if you haven't yet so you don't miss any of my Outlander reviews. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you soon. Bye! Also, quite a few of you mentioned that there was a book that Diana Gabaldon wrote about Master Raymond, and maybe the Comte Saint-Germain as well, that explains a little bit about them and what they do or something like that, which is kind of exciting. So I'm gonna wanna check those out. So thank you for the recommendation, because you know I love Master Raymond. I'm still hoping he comes back this season, but you know.